Hi and welcome. I'm Giselle Gomez from Intel, here to tell you about the latest Intel GPA news and updates. The 2019.3 release has added multiple features to Graphics Frame Analyzer, Trace Analyzer, and the new Intel GPA SDK. For this release, we've made the UI scalable with small, medium, and large scales across all tools, improved the functionality of Multiframe View with additional navigation and capture features, enabled a new resource view mode in Graphics Frame Analyzer, implemented parallel event execution for GPU events in Graphics Trace Analyzer, and continued the development of the Intel GPA SDK feature set. To begin, Intel GPA has added the possibility of scaling the UI of any tool in the tool suite. Using the Settings button in any tool, select the UI scale size to make all UI elements and fonts smaller or larger depending on your preference. Each tool has its own UI scale that is independent of other tools, allowing you to set each tool's size individually. Secondly, our team has added a new event track to Graphics Trace Analyzer, Parallel Event Execution. This track takes parallelization into account, showing a more accurate timeline of when a GPU event begins and ends its execution. To view any parallel GPU work for your application, take a trace capture through Graphics Monitor by selecting the Trace button and selecting the appropriate API from the dropdown. Use the Ctrl+Shift+T shortcut to trigger the trace capture. This feature is only available for DirectX 11 applications. Graphics Frame Analyzer has also received a boost in functionality with a new view mode for resources in the Resource Viewer. When applying experiments in Graphics Frame Analyzer, the tool provides a diff view of the selected resource. This view is the visual difference between the original resource and the resource associated with an applied change. To turn on the diff view mode, navigate to the View Mode dropdown in the Resource Viewer of Graphics Frame Analyzer. Select Diff Mode from the available options to reveal a view of the resource that shows only the affected regions from the original render target. With the implementation of this feature, you can now see both the performance and visual impact of any experiment on the resource. In addition to the Diff View mode, Graphics Frame Analyzer received a functionality boost to the Multiframe View. In this release, we've included the ability to collect system-wide time-based metrics during stream capture. With these metrics enabled, new tracks will appear in Multiframe View below the Frame Selection track that add context for the system at capture time. To view time-based metrics in Multiframe View, go to Settings in Graphics Monitor and turn on the System-Wide Time-Based GPU Metrics button under the Metrics tab. Metrics will now be automatically collected during stream captures. We have also made it possible to capture screenshots while taking a stream. Screenshots allow you to preview a frame in the timeline view and as a full-size image when a frame is selected. Enabling screenshots can be done by setting a frame or a time interval for triggering the screenshot under the Stream tab in Graphics Monitor Settings. Once enabled, knowing where you are within a stream is as easy as hovering over a frame in the timeline view. Many of the features shown already have also been added to Intel GPA SDK. However, we've also developed capabilities outside of the previously mentioned functionalities, which include the ability to replay a range of callables for DirectX 12 streams, Vulkan pipeline statistics and timestamp query manager support, and an event dispatch system to communicate between decoupled systems, enabling interlayer communication. Thank you for watching. For more information about the Intel GPA 2019.3 release and to download GPA for free, see the links. Remember to like this video and subscribe to the Intel Software YouTube channel for more Intel GPA news and updates.
Hey everyone, thanks for watching this video. If you liked it and haven't seen any of our other videos, subscribe to the Intel Software YouTube channel. You can also connect with other developers and enthusiasts in the comments, and we'll see you all next time.